Hi, this is Asa, and welcome to my audio experience. This is Asa RX Experience. If you haven't signed up or subscribed to the podcast, you should. We put a podcast out every single day to be able to encourage you, equip you, give you hope with everything that you have going on in your life. We want to help you every single day. So make sure to join in, get on the podcast, get it coming to you, or go to it at all the outlets, iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, it's iHeart, Pandora. It's on all of them, Spotify. You can find it everywhere, but we're here for you. Really, we want to help you and encourage you and equip you. And on that note, we're going to go to the phones and talk to Alice. Hi, Alice.
I've heard a lot of talk about alkaline water, drinking that. And I haven't seen or heard anything contrary to drinking it. I don't know what effect it has on you, but I have friends who claim that it's like a cure-all. I'd just like to know what you think about it.
Well, I'll tell you, there's always going to be the latest remedy and gimmick for whatever it is, okay? And water, the whole idea of water, first of all, water is extremely important, like the most important thing we can put in our body. So the quality of your water needs to be good. I just get excited that people drink water. Now, it is true that some tap water systems are not the best, and the Environmental Protection agencies have listed all the different chemicals that are in waters that can be toxic, different water supplies. And of course, it's not true for every system in every part of the country. However, quality of water is important, and limiting the chemicals that you take in is your best option for whatever you're dealing with, right? So if you're going to have a game plan, it's good to have that kind of game plan. So I always encourage you, if you're looking, when you're looking at water alone, is just make sure, number one, you're drinking it. Is if it's alkaline or reverse osmosis or whatever, distilled water is always a good choice. It is. It's the easiest way to get purity in water, the processing of that. So I like distilled water quite a bit. And then people say, well, it takes the minerals out of your body. Yeah, but I mean, if you're eating a good, healthy diet, there's no issue with that. So, and a lot of waters that are spring water can put inorganic minerals back in the body that we don't really need. So it's kind of a catch-22. However, I think it's one of the best options that you can do is just get your half your body weight in ounces of water. So if it's alkaline, Kangen water, all that, sure, great. Is it going to cure everything? Well, look, water, we have this thing in our body. Like, let's just get down to the nitty-gritty. Okay, you're listening to Asa RX, by the way, 888-283-7272. If you want to give us a call, you can join in or send me an email. Go to asarx.com, and you can shoot me an email there or hit me up on any of my social media at AsaRxTV. So you definitely, without a shadow of a doubt, can you know, get better water in certain instances, but it's just getting it in. That is the key. And that's what I really am a big fan of. So half your body weight. If you weigh 200 pounds, drink 100 ounces of water a day. And again, provided there's no major kidney malfunction, that should be an okay number. You know, otherwise your kidney doc, the big nephrologist, will need to weigh in on that. But for the most part, the average healthy person, that's a good rule of thumb that we all go by. And if you're an athlete, or if you live in hotter climate, warmer climates and you work outside, then you're going to need to increase that probably another 30 to 40 ounces, they say. Just depends. But that's usually the game plan. Water is, we have this buffering system in the body. So when you start talking about pH, you know, the median number is 6.8 to 7.2. Okay. That's kind of this roundabout number. And yes, you can have more alkaline water. There are alkaline foods and more acidic foods. But what it's like, I heard, and I talk about the pH system in my book. And I believe in it. Just know that it's not the end all be all, because your body has this intelligent buffering system already built in. And because it's already built in, then it'll keep your, even if you had an acidic food and you put it in your body, the body's going to buffer that and make it more neutral. If you take in a real high alkaline food, the body's going to buffer that and make it more neutral. So it's not like you eat a food or drink water and the body just stays alkaline. It can lean toward more of an alkaline state. It can lean more toward an acidic state. But our body has this thing called homeostasis. And it's kind of the overall vibe of the body to want to be in balance. It just does. That's why extremes don't work with the body very long. Like you can work out a certain way, the body will get used to it and stop responding. You can eat a certain way, the body will get used to it and it'll stop responding. The body likes constant change. Change is the only thing that can really disrupt the body enough to make it transition. And so with water, keep it simple. Make sure it's clean, pure water. Don't get hung up on the details. Don't spend a ton of money on some machine. Okay. I'm not naming any names. I'll tell you one thing to spend your money on that I think is a wise choice. If you have a home that is going to be your home, you know, not like you're getting it for a year, you're renting someplace, but they have whole house water filtration systems. And the entire whole house water filtration system, that's a good purchase. Because then you don't have to get individual filters for everything. It's one big filter that filters all the water. And that, whether you're cooking, drinking, showering, remember, whatever touches your skin, 75% goes into your bloodstream, right? So whatever you shower in, that water counts as well. So all that matters when it really comes down to it. And it can make a big impact with your overall health. And again, for the long term. So the whole house filtration systems, I am a big fan of that. 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Lines are open with questions about your health. Give us a call or go online, go to asarx.com. If you haven't checked out the Asa RX Experience podcast, it's on every single day. And it's, of course, some great content we can give you, encourage you, equip you to be better. We want to help you live your potential and become the best version of you. Jacob in New Orleans said, I had a biopsy on my prostate a year ago, and the recent test shows everything's great. Awesome. That's great news. But I have discomfort in the groin and bladder. I'd get that looked at. I mean, if the prostate's doing okay, depending on your, and again, I don't have all the details, but it depends on a couple things. You could have a hernia. Giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to asarx.com and get your free book today.
To find out more, connect with On Call Radio online at InShapeNetwork.com.
That's 888-283-7272. What are you struggling with? Let's talk about it. Your health, your life. Remember, if the body can get sick, it can also get well. Lifestyle is the medicine. So the choices we make today can and will determine the kind of health we're going to have. So we want to help you. If you haven't found a lifestyle provider, that's someone in your area that believes just like we do, then check out our providers there at the website. Go to asarx.com. Our providers can really dig in. And you know what you really want, just so you know, you've probably never heard the term, but I'm going to give it to you just so you understand it. But it's provider-guided personalized nutrition. It all needs to be customized, okay? It's not one size fits all. It's not something cool you hear on my show. You go to the vitamin store and get it because this new herb is supposed to be amazing. Yeah, if I read some research and it is, that's great. But what does your body need? See, the thing is, we all have nutritional deficiencies that we develop over time. And you don't need to do blind nutrition. Blind nutrition is definitely not the way to go. You need provider-guided or doctor-guided nutrition, somebody that can look at lab tests, that can look at your own body chemistry, know exactly what's going on, and put the right kind of plan together that's customized for you. That's where you're going to get the results, and that's where the biggest difference will come in how you're operating and how your body works. So that's the ultimate key that you have to look for, okay, is going in that direction. And on the show, we'll help you get there. If you need a provider, let us know. Go to asarx.com and let my team know. They'll find you somebody in your area. All right. So heart is a big issue. The American Heart Association made a statement in a zero tolerance approach for children's exposure to secondhand smoke. So cigarette smoke. You know, I talk about smoking. It's interesting because I read articles, of course, that we bring here to the show and studies that they're doing and whatnot. You'll hear me talk a lot about that. But what's interesting is I just can't believe people are still smoking. And they say that cell phone radiation and the effects we're just now getting to see what some long-term studies are showing us. But they say that like keeping a cell phone on your body is going to be the same thing as cigarette smoke was 50 years ago, right? Just the not really knowing, kind of knowing, but not really having the long-term studies, and now they have them. So I can't believe people still smoke. You ever go to the airport and you see the big smoking room? People are in that room, they're just hammering away at the cigarettes. Like, it blows me away. So it still blows me away when I go into a restaurant and they're smoking there. Like, I can't even, especially with kids. So I'll get off my smoking rant. I know it's addictive. I get it. If you're addicted to it, I'm sorry. If you need help, seriously, let us know. And we'll see if we can get a provider to help you in some way. But parents should consider making their children's environment smoke-free. I totally agree. I mean, I grew up in a home where both parents smoked. They quit, thank the Lord, at a certain age. I think I was probably around, you know, maybe teenager, 12 or 13, when they quit. But, you know, and there was a marked difference. I grew up with bronchitis every year, walking pneumonia, all these lung conditions. And it was like, I mean, literally, I would stay in the house for a month. The doctor wouldn't let me go out. And what's interesting about that pediatrician, old school, he wouldn't let me go out and get fresh air because of the bronchitis. I'm inside the house where all the smoke was happening. And they wondered why it lasted a month. Like, that didn't even make sense. So I look back at some of those things and I think, how crazy is that? But the children that are exposed to cigarette smoke may develop early heart disease as adults due to poorly functioning, stiffer blood vessels that the smoke causes. And some babies who are exposed to cigarette smoke while in the womb may be at risk for sudden death during infancy. So along with damaging arteries, secondhand smoke has been linked to other heart disease risk factors such as obesity, high cholesterol, and insulin resistance, which is associated with type 2 diabetes, they said. Also, the children of smokers are more likely to become smokers themselves. An estimated 24 million non-smoking children and teens are exposed to secondhand smoke in the U.S., but that exposure is largely from parents who smoke, they said. So it's encouraging adults, of course, to quit, because your kids don't do what we say. They do what we do. You don't think they're watching? Let me tell you something. They're watching. They're watching everything that you do, how you do everything you do, why you do everything you do. They're watching everything. So it's a big deal. So parents, make an example, be an example, live an example in front of your kids so they have someone to look to know which way to go. 888-283-7272. Lines are open. You can give us a call or go to the website, go to asarx.com. That's asarx.com. Get on the phones and go with Sophia. Hi, Sophia.
Yes, I'm calling about joint pains, inflammation in the lower part of my back, down my hip and down my leg. I'm wondering the best thing to take for this. I have had back surgery, but I'm wondering the best thing to take for these aches in my joints, ankle, knee, lower back, neck, down my hips, down my legs. Sometimes it's like a toothache pain. It's worse than a toothache pain. It's an achy pain. Mm-hmm. And I'm wondering what's the best thing to take.
Well, there's a couple things. When you have that type of pain, okay, it's not about what to take. I think we're all conditioned about what to take. So everybody at a certain age is going to have a certain level of arthritis in their backs, okay? And depending on how much you weigh and your activity level and all that, that is going to play a role too. So what I'm about to tell you is really important because you, with the joint pain that's going down like that, it's all nerve related. It's coming from the low back. But most of that could be due to the disc in between the bones getting thinner and thinner. It could be to some, the way your back is positioned. A chiropractic physician would be one of your best options to get started with down that path, in my opinion, because it's going to be non-surgical and it's going to be a full evaluation in that area to make sure, because it sounds like it's neurological, but then your primary care needs to look at it too, just to make sure they get some labs and whatever. But I would get somebody to take a good overall look at that. Because fish oil and omega-3 fatty acids can play a role in the inflammation cycle. So that's one thing. There's things you can do, but it's the root cause. What's the root cause of it? And it could be muscle instability. If you're sedentary and not exercising, you've got to get, exercise needs to be a part of your life 5-6 days a week, no matter what. So I think that's a good starting point as well. Are you ready to chow? It's time for Keto Chow. When it comes to eating healthy, the keto diet has become one of the nutrition leaders in optimizing health, losing unwanted weight, and reaching your health and wellness goals. No extravagant cooking, no long kitchen cleanup, and most importantly, especially for me, it's convenient. Just put quality keto chow powder in a bottle, add some heavy whipping cream or your favorite fat, a little water, and boom, shake it up and you're ready to chow. Keto chow tastes amazing. So make keto chow easy for you and your family today with keto chow. Let's go chow. Visit keto chow online at ketochow.xyz. That's ketochow.xyz. So taking a decline is a big deal when it comes to mental decline and having too little exercise when you're young. Now, that wasn't an issue for me. I think over-exercise. Of course, I'm still an exercise fanatic now. But I was a kid. It's like pulling me to get in the house to eat dinner was like a chore. My mother, bless her heart, as we say, in the South, right? Trying to wrangle me to get me in to eat dinner, and then I didn't want to eat my vegetables, but that's a whole nother story. So, and that's what I'm preaching today. So yes, I did struggle with it. Didn't like vegetables, fought everybody on it. Yep. I was that kid for sure. Now I love them though. All right. So too much TV and too little exercise. We're talking about it. So even early, they say mid adulthood may be critical periods for promotion of physical activity to keep memory and thinking strong in old age. Lead researcher Tina Hong said in a news release from the Alzheimer's Association, she said that a Northern California Institute of Research and Education in San Francisco is slated to present her team's findings at the annual meeting of the Alzheimer's Association in D.C. Prior studies have suggested that physical activity later in life may help protect against mental decline. In their study, the researchers tracked more than 3,200 white and black Americans age 18 to 30. And they look really at their physical activity levels and television viewing to make their decisions in the study. Well, what's interesting about it is they found that 17% of the participants had a long-term pattern of low physical activity, 11% a long-term pattern of high levels of television viewing. So thinking and memory tests were conducted over after 25 years, according to the researchers. And those with both long-term, low physical activity and high television viewing were nearly two times more likely to have poor mental function in midlife. So while the study couldn't prove cause and effect, they added that because research indicates Alzheimer's and other dementias develop over several decades, increasing physical activity and reducing sedentary behavior beginning in early adulthood may have a significant public health impact. So the experts agreed without a doubt, it's consistent, that when it comes down to mental decline, which is a big deal, we're seeing it now. I got to tell you, we're seeing mental decline now more in dementia and Alzheimer's more than ever. I mean, we're seeing it now in a massive, massive way. And the good news is we've got better ways of treating it and managing it. But still, nonetheless, to see someone go through that, family member, loved one, whatever, is really hard. It's very challenging and difficult to watch. So I want to encourage you to really dig in. If you know somebody that struggles with any symptoms that you're seeing with any form of mental decline, then you want to jump in and really make an impact and get them to somebody that can truly, truly help them. Because that is a big deal. One of the greatest things you can do is help in that way and get somebody the help that they need. 888-283-7272. You can give us a call. That's 888-283-7272. We want you to be a part of the show, so always give us a call. And also, if you can send us an email, we can make you part of the show that way as well. If you want me to answer something in private, just tell them when you call. And we can set something up to answer in private as well if you just kind of don't want to be on the air. A lot of people do that, and they just have a question. So let us know. Email us to asarx.com. We're always here for you. That's what we're all about. And if you're looking for a provider in your area, a lifestyle provider, someone that does exactly what we do and helps you really get to the next level with your health and life, just give us a call, same number, 888-283-7272, and we've got a whole team that can help you get everything that you need that way. So what about blueberries? Are you a blueberries fan? Man, I love blueberries. They're so good for you, right? I'm going to talk about some of the health benefits that we see with blueberries, and I'm going to do that in just a moment. First, I want to jump on the phone, though, and talk to someone who's been waiting for us, Miss Maddie. Hi, Maddie.
I'm calling in action about a good vitamin for thyroid disease.
Right. And, you know, that's such a good question. The reason I say that is we always jump when we get a thyroid issue in medications and whatnot. And people are like, okay, what do I need to take? What do I need to do? And all that jazz, right? So if you're taking any of the medications like Synthroid, let's say you got low thyroid function and they put you on Synthroid or levothyroxine, as we call it, which is the most common, but there's also Armor, which I'm a huge fan of as well. They've kind of remodeled and redone Armor, but people are still getting really good results with it. The key is with thyroid, before you jump into, hey, take this, do this supplement, whatever, is iodine. Iodine is one of the big, big deficiencies that we have that can cause issues with the thyroid itself. So always have people look and see what their iodine levels are first before they jump in. Because if you start looking at your iodine levels and they're super low, but you still take Synthroid and all that, you may not really need it. You may have just had, remember, the body typically gets deficiencies for the reasons of why it breaks down. And that's usually the number one reason that it breaks down. The body's not getting something that it needs, and it needs it. So first and foremost, you got to figure that out. But don't forget, too, that even if you're taking the medication, you got to step back and say, what's really causing it? Like, what's the root cause of this whole deal, right? What's the root cause of it? And that's what you got to figure out, because it could be the pituitary gland. It could be the adrenals. It could be other issues. Usually the thyroid is never primary. It's never the primary condition. It typically is always secondary to another condition that's going on. So remember, here, we're all about the root cause. We're all about the root reason of why things break down and why things don't work and what's causing it and all of that jazz. So we need to figure that out. That's why I like to look at it from that perspective, is when you're looking at thyroid. I mean, I think iodine, if you're just asking for straight up what can help it, there's glandulars and things you can use. Tyrosine's a really good amino acid that's helpful for the thyroid. But you don't just start taking stuff. Remember, I do not advocate blind nutrition. The only blind nutrition that I'm a big fan of is not even vitamin D. Like, I don't think you need to be taking vitamin D unless you got a provider guiding you, because it's fat soluble. If you take too much, it becomes toxic. If you take too little, it's going to literally mess up almost every system in your body. Is not going to work at its peak level. Okay. From inflammation to your hormones, because it is a hormone, by the way, it's not even a vitamin, to your immune system, to your ability to build lean muscle tissue, to brain function. I mean, the list goes on and on. I mean, it's a rock star, but you need to know what your numbers are. The only four things that are cool are what we call the foundational four. It's the only blind nutrition that I really support. And the foundational four is a good multi-nutrient formula. So you get a little bit of everything that you need that's organic. You need something to cover your gut health. You need something to cover your ability to break down your foods. And you also need something to cover any of the fatty acids that your body needs, because you don't get all those from food. So those in a whole food form, all four of those nutrients are very important. Drinking out of our new shaker bottle, really, really cool. And you better be drinking your water every single day. Don't you better remember half your body weight. But our new shaker bottles are awesome. They say unstoppable on them, because you are. And also talks about living your potential. So if you haven't got one yet, go to AsaRx.com. I think they're like $9. It's not much at all, but go and check it out and grab one of those. They're pretty, pretty awesome. And don't forget our free book, my best-selling book, hardback cover. I'm giving it to you for free. Why am I doing that? Because I want to help you. So if you just cover a little bit of the shipping cost, just cover the shipping, I'll pay for the book and I'll send it to you. Go to the website, go to AsaRx.com and click on the free book offer deal, and they'll get you a copy. It's pretty amazing. So grab a copy of the book, I'll send it to you, and you can get started really going down your path of what you need to live a healthy lifestyle. And the book is amazing. It's a bestseller everywhere. And it was just been amazing. So it takes you from where you are to where you need to be with your health. And literally, it could not cover more. I mean, every review we get is like, this book has everything in it. Like, I knew nothing about health, or the people that were like high-end gurus with health read it and they're just blown away by the material. And it is, it's good. It's helpful. It's inspiring. And it will really get you to the next level with your health and with your life. So I want to jump in real quick on blueberries. Blueberries are amazing. They really are a superstar health food, and tons of antioxidants. They have these powerful different anthocyanins in it and flavanols that are just amazing for your overall body. They've got cardiovascular benefits. They've done studies on this, and they can actually lower the LDL, that's the bad cholesterol, and raise the good cholesterol, the HDL. Pretty amazing. Recent studies have also shown that there's a thing called nitric oxide syndrome. So the types of cancers they've studied with it, breast cancer, colon, esophageal, and ones of the small intestines, they have definitely shown an increasing percentage of help from just using blueberries. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. You're listening to Asa RX. Did you know that you can listen to the Asa RX audio experience on Spotify and Pandora? For all the ways to watch and listen, check out our show page at asarx.com/experience.
Connect with On Call Radio and watch On Call TV at InShape Network.
...7272. Lines are open with questions about your health. Give us a call or go to the website. Go to AsaRx.com. And remember, we're giving you a free book. So go to the website. We're giving you a free book. Or go to MyFreeHealthBook.com. That's MyFreeHealthBook.com. com, and we'll be glad to send you a copy of my best-selling book, hardback. All you got to do is just cover the shipping. It's a little bit of shipping cost. And just cover that, and I'll send you my hardback cover copy of my book. It's worth like $30. We'll send it to you for free. Okay? Absolutely free. I want you to have it, to be a tool and to give you the ability to really do well and to crush it. And we want to help you along the way, no matter what, so you can do really, really well. That's what this whole thing is about. It's about helping you live your potential and becoming the best version of you. Donnie in Atlanta, Georgia, the ATL. He says, I have atrial fib, and I'd love to take care of my heart. I've been dealing with taking medication, but the doctor wants me to increase medication. What do you think? Well, AFib, you got to first look at it. Like, what is AFib? And then what are some natural ways to support it? Well, atrial fibrillation is irregular heartbeat, basically. And it creates a fluttering. There can be different patterns of it. There's different theories of why this happens. I think it's a strong genetic component. I've seen some studies on that. I'm okay with that. But the bigger issue is, from a long-term piece, what's going to give you the most results and what's going to cause you, your body to work in the best way possible for the long term. And that's the bigger piece that you really want to look at. So I would start there and focus in on that, because if you're looking at it from atrial fib, it's usually a B vitamin deficiency. If you really want to step into it, it's usually B vitamins, because here's the deal. All right. Most of our B vitamins are found in vegetables. Okay. Now, I think we're heavily B vitamin deficient, personally. I just do. And I've seen it in clinical practice for years and years and years. It's usually one of the top ones that we see and we deal with. Okay. So that's first and foremost. However, what's interesting about that is that 1.5% of Americans actually eat vegetables. So think about the vitamin deficiency when people are just eating things like meat, breads, potatoes, carbs, sugars. They're not getting the nutrients that they need. Now, this is why people start breaking down. Like, I love my mother for making us all eat vegetables and making me do it when I was a kid. Like, I didn't like it, but she was old school, right? And made me eat them. Broccoli. I mean, I had something green every night, like asparagus, Brussels sprouts. You know, I was ready to lay hands on some Brussels sprouts. They were so bad. I can just remember them as a kid, right? As just a kid, having to eat those things is like literally, you think about life and all we go through. As a kid, I was like, Brussels sprouts? I remember one time taking the Brussels sprouts and actually putting them in the napkin and hiding them. So I was like, telling my parents I ate them and I didn't. Like, it was that bad, right? So what's funny about that is their vegetables are the only thing that give you the B vitamins for the most part. So if you're not getting them, then you're pretty deficient in them. And that creates a whole different issue to deal with. So I would encourage you to look at B vitamins, vitamin C, and then check into iodine. Because if you have an iodine deficiency, sometimes that can trigger AFib as well. Because the thyroid, don't forget the thyroid, is kind of like the switch and the regulator for the heart rate and rhythm. And if that's not working right, then, I mean, it's just not going to work right. So you got to make sure everything's clicking and ticking the way that it needs to. Okay, 888-283-7272. That's 888-283-7272. Give us a call. You're listening to Asa Rx. Go to asarx.com. Don't forget your free book. Go to asarx.com. The free book offer is right there. You can pick it up. Check it out. We'll send you a copy for free, hardback copy. You just cover a little bit of the shipping, and we will take care of the rest. All right, let's get on the phone and go to Mary Ann. Hi, Mary Ann.
I just wondered if you can, the milk thistle you mentioned, the milk thistle for liver problems. I just wondered if you get that at a health food store, or do you have to have a prescription for it? And what else did you say was good for the liver? And how much water should someone that's diagnosed with congestive heart failure drink a day? I know you said a regular person,
yeah,
or a normal person should drink half their body weight.
Right.
But I realize with congestional heart failure, it might be different.
It is. It is. And one of the things, it's a great question, Marianne. With milk thistle in the liver, it's good, okay? It's not the end-all be-all. Things like choline are really good. L-theanine are really good, and that's an amino acid. So there's a lot you can do to support the liver. Dandelion is just fantastic. You can get dandelion tea, and it's real regenerative for the liver. So all of that is beneficial. But the liver is so regenerative. Like the liver is so powerful just on its own, and it does really, really well to recover and regenerate when it's taking a beating. It's really cool how well that works. So that's one thing you got to realize on that note, that the liver is resilient, and it's going to work and do great no matter what. So I wouldn't worry too much about that. Now, so milk thistle is good, I guess, roundabout way, but it's more about your daily routine, your eating habits consistently, staying away from alcohol, staying away from a lot of the sugars, making sure there's no fat around the liver, no fatty liver, and exercising. I mean, exercise is key. If you're not exercising 5 to 6 days a week, you're not going to hit your potential. It's just not possible. It's not. Your body was designed to move, not sit. And I think we've got too much. It's like the biggest disease we deal with. I think our thoughts become our biggest disease, but I think inactivity is definitely number two, without a doubt. So I would encourage you to look at that. And, you know, as far as water goes for congestive heart failure, you really want to talk to your doctor, because at different stages, you can do different things. And the water intake, depending on where things are, is really going to be the determining factor. So it is. But the good news is that if you get that calculated and get the right numbers in, the body will respond really well. Getting enough water is a key, and we just don't. And it's a major, major player in feeling better. Puts another hour in the charts wrapping this up. I want to thank our producer, Mr. Fig, Derek Allen, also our chief engineer, John Garrison. Go tell one person something you learned on the show. Together, we can transform the health of our friends, our families, and our communities. You're listening to the show. It helps you become the best version of you. This is Asa RX.
Did you know you could listen to the Asa RX audio experience on Spotify and Pandora? For all the ways to watch and listen, check out our show page at asarx.com/experience.
Hi, it's Asa. I'm giving you a copy of my best-selling book for free to help you in your health journey today. I'll pay for the book. All you do is just cover the small shipping and handling costs. Go to asarx.com and get your free book today.
This episode is over, but check episode notes for links to products and services you've heard about on this episode. Thanks for listening and subscribing. Please share the Asa RX audio experience with others and stay in touch by giving us your comment or review.